Hey everybody, this is Tobias Uñete coming to you guys to make a video on the Orisha Oshumari. The reason why I have decided to make this video and release a video on this Orisha is because in the last few weeks I have literally have had several people come to me from different parts of the world, technically, come to me and speak to me about the Orisha Oshumare and ask me questions about Oshumare and information, what did I know, etc., etc., and like, you know, whatnot and whatnot. So I just said, let me sit down and let's have a conversation about the Orisha Oshumare that we have today. In Candomblé, the aspect of Candomblé, Oshumare has been maintained and has been worshipped a lot more than in the aspect of Lukumi. In the aspect of Lukumi, the religious aspect of Lukumi, Oshumare has been more recently resurfaced, has regained popularity amongst practitioners. And that is the honest truth. Like, some of you guys want to get all this information and some of this. That is what I can consider as the most honest of the things to say. There are different ways and different stories that go around as to how one fundamental Oshumare came about, or how another fundamental Oshumare came about, or how whatever. But the truth is that the conclusion that I can come to say, that I can sit here and like analyze, you know, by myself, is that Oshumare has resurfaced within the Lukumi tradition mainly, and has been very well accepted by many priests and priestesses and many people that have received it. Many of the people that watch me and or that are watching this video now have already heard of Oshumare very well and or have received Oshumare themselves. So Oshumare is an Orisha that has been worshipped in other areas but has been resurrected or resurfaced broadly within the Lukumi tradition also. Oshumare is a serpentine rainbow. It is a rainbow. It is the universal spectrum of colors. It is the Orisha of colors. It's the Orisha of brightness. It is the Orisha of view and everything that you see and everything that you intake. Okay, it's the Orisha of communication. Oshumare is an Orisha of wealth and prosperity. It's an Orisha that is deeply connected to Ochun and to emotions, and it's deeply connected to Yemaya in actions. It is the Orisha of movement and the Orisha of like continuity. Oshumare is related with sound waves and or that which carries something. So this is why it's said that Oshumare had become, because of all of Oshumare's colors, Oshumare became Olofi's favorite Orisha. Thus, Olofi instructed Oshumare that he will come down to earth and then return back to the heavens. And that's what we have, the rainbow that comes down, touches, and then releases back. Or the spectrum of light that appears and then it disappears once, or it blends right back into the reality that you normally see. Oshumare is a deep, intense Orisha, but this is what I have come to experience after having received several forms of Oshumare and or understanding my personal worship of Oshumare. Because everybody's gonna sit here, I'm gonna give a few more facts but of Oshumare worship, but everybody sits and people wanna argue about things, and there's no point in arguing, there's just the point of worshiping, okay? In the point of worshiping, it has come to my attention, it has come to my personal Ache influence, that Oshumare, there's two major forms of Oshumare that are being given or that people are receiving and whatnot. That is the Candomblé form of Oshumare and or the Lukumi form of Oshumare. And the Lukumi, we're gonna start with the Lukumi form of Oshumare because that's what most of you that watch me are probably practicing. The Lukumi form of Oshumare took me a little bit to receive, a little bit longer for me to actually receive that form of Oshumare, because it just happened that way, and I personally wasn't ready, I guess, to receive it until the point that I received it. Now, the form of Lukumi of Oshumare that we keep in Oshumare, with Oshumare, has its own personal controversy as to where it came from or who started it, etc., or what they used, or what these people used, or whatever that they did to reinstate this worship, etc. But the form of Lukumi has definitely gained a lot of popularity. Many people have received that Oshumare, this aspect of Oshumare, and that manifestation of Oshumare, that fundamento of Oshumare. In the form of Candomblé, people have, there has been people that have gotten contact or flown or, you know, visited other places and received things, and, you know, different ceremonies have been made and people have received extra things from different places, and there's mixtures of people receiving things from different traditions and back and forth. And then, so I have, as a personal form of worship, the Candomblé aspect has been more male dominated or male manifested versus the Lukumi aspect that has been more female manifested. And I remember that when I received the Candomblé aspect of Oshumare, I definitely felt more of this empowerment and more of this like virility and more of this excitement. When I received, years later, when I received the Lukumi aspect, I ended up receiving it from a lady. Well, I received this one also from a lady, but I received it from a much tougher lady, and I received it from a or an aspect of Yemaya that was a lot more like intense. And this Oshumare came with a lot more sassiness and a lot more feminine, like hyped up feminine qualities and whatnot. And honestly speaking, when I, you know, when I received the Lukumi Fundamento, when I brought it home, you know, this is one of like those spiritual experiences that I have to just share, because some people sometimes like forget how to interact with the orishas or something or whatnot. But when I brought the Lukumi aspect of Oshumare to the house and I placed Oshumare for 7 days on the estera, and you know, I let Oshumare rest and whatnot, then I ended up placing Oshumare where they were gonna live, and I just like, you know, started fixing everything around, and then I went ahead and I was walking out of the Iguadung, and I heard, I swear, you know, there was just like one of those like weird moments, weird spiritual moments, psychotic moments. I heard Oshumare just like hiss, this very intense hiss, that I turned around and I looked, and out of the sobera, like, oh, coming out from inside of the sobera, came out this entity, this very Medusa-like entity, this very serpentine, definite female with breasts entity, that I just, like, I stared at this entity, and I was just like, oh my God, what the hell am I seeing? And I stared at this female entity, and she just like looked at me and just like looked at me and looked at me for a few seconds and just like turned around and slithered right back into the sopera, and just like the vision was over. And I was like, what did I just see? An orisha experience, to whatever manifestation that you see, that you notice, is what should give you the insight of as to your worship of the orisha. There is, everybody wants to focus on the birthing of the orisha and the transition of the orisha, and whether they drew the little rainbow from orisha to orisha, whether they did this or whether they did that, or whether they fed it a dog, or whether they fed it a rooster, or whether they fed it a hen. Or I'm not here to argue about your ceremony of Oshumare. I'm here to talk about your worship of Oshumare. What have you done with Oshumare? When have you placed flowers to Oshumare, or coconuts to Oshumare, or adimu to Oshumare, or mashed potato adimu in the shape of a snake to Oshumare? When have you lit, you know, I have spoken with several people on the worship of Oshumare, but many people are just have Oshumare there. I don't just want to have Oshumare, I want to worship Oshumare. I want you to come and worship Oshumare. So What have you done? How many of you have been holding up the besides at the birthing ceremony? Because this is what happens. This is what happens, that people go to the birthing ceremony of the orisha and they figure like, I received the orisha, that's it. Okay. Like, you don't just have a child and then you just abandon the child. It's like you continue every day to interact with the child and or with the orisha. What have you done afterwards to do with the orisha? So after having had that vision, I ended up covering Oshumare with Ibuaro, or with how do you say this blue thing? With Añil. With Aro, I ended up covering Oshumare with Aro until Oshumare decided to, or spoke to me again and told me, okay, to take the Aro off. And I realized as the Aro is coming off of Oshumare, I realized that it was a shade of a vision. It was an Iroso vision being taken off of my face. It was an Iroso vision being taken off of my eyesight, that Oshumare has been removing, as to the beauty of the different forms of worship and the different forms of expressions. This was a gift that I realized that Oshumare has been gifting me that had been hidden. The expression, the gift of expression, the gift of duality. Oshumare is deeply associated in Lukumi with Yemaya. It's very interesting that Oshumare has become very, very deeply. This is a Lukumi. This is a major Lukumi fusion that Oshumare has become associated with Yemaya, because Oshumare has always been more associated with Oshun and a connection made with Oshun. Now in Lukumi, Oshumare has become more associated with Yemaya, that even the Eleke to Oshumare. The other day I logged into Facebook, you know. The other day I looked into Facebook and there were elekes. There was someone who was selling elekes or had made elekes and were advertising their elekes of Oshumare and of Lukungete. And I thought it was beautiful, because I had told myself that I wanted to be, many years ago before I received these orishas, I realized that I wanted to be one of the people that would see the manifestation of these orishas within the Yoruba, within the Lukumi expansion. And I am seeing it, you know. So that definitely made my day, but there were some differences and whatnot. But you can see in the influence of the Lukumi style, the Yemaya connection. So in the Lukumi style, it's mainly blue or light blue that it gets used, and then with a rainbow section, etc. This eleke that I saw the other day was 7 dark blue and 7 crystals, which is a typical pattern of Yemaya. 7 dark blue, 7 dark crystals, 7 dark blue, 7 dark crystals, and then a rainbow section in between. So it was clearly a Yemaya and rainbow clear mixture of the two. And that is definitely a big fusion that has happened. And an association that has happened within the Lukumi tradition, whereas Oshumare has always been more associated with Oshun. In other traditions, that Oshumare has been more like Candomblé, referring to Candomblé specifically, mainly, and or some form of traditional aspects. The beads of Oshumare have been either yellow with black stripes, or they have been green with yellow stripes. The green and yellow is used in certain aspects of candomblé, but this is the major, the yellow with the black stripes is the major aspect or the major color combination that is used for them. Whereas in Lukumi, the major aspect is sections of blue with rainbow sections in between, and or some of these beads mixed in between there also because of the colorful effect. The truth being that Oshumare can take any color. I have another eleke of Oshumare somewhere that must be hanging somewhere else, and I had a gacho that I had made for me, so that must be hanging in another place. But there, Oshumare can take just about any eleke, because Oshumare owns all colors, all color combinations, all color associations. Oshumare, to me, has always definitely appeared more manly. manly and or androgynous in aspect. Some people want to see Oshimare as more female because of a serpentine aspect. Whether Oshimare is male or female, that is not point to debate. Oshimare can take either form, I'm sure. And that is mainly the point of many other schools of thought, that Oshimare takes different forms of manifestation. When Oshimare becomes the rainbow, then Oshimare takes a male manifestation. And then when Oshimare becomes the serpent, Oshimare takes a more serpentine manifestation. Or more male and or female quality. So, what have you done to Oshimare? You know, offerings of flowers, of different color flowers to Oshimare, difference of cutting up different fruits to Oshimare. All of this is placed inside of, oh, Oshimare also takes, before I forget, a necklace that is made of shells and whatnot. In both aspects, in both aspects, Oshimare usually goes with a ha, which I thought was interesting because I first received my first fundamental of Oshimare that was consecrated was my candomblé aspect of Oshimare, which was male. And I received it with a ha. And there was some form of apprehension as to why it had a ha and whatnot at some points. But later on, when other people received it, they also ended up receiving it with a ha from the Lukumi aspect. So people create a ha for Oshimare in both aspects for the most part. Some form of hooked, very similar hooked tool that is very similar to Nanas. Now that is some form of mix, that may be of some form of mixture, and or that may be a aspect of unison of the Orisha between different traditions or anything like that. But I thought it was interesting that as it carried over throughout the years into Lukumi, it definitely, the ha aspect got maintained. Now I definitely need to make a new ha for mine, but that is another point. But either way, cutting up different fruits for Oshimare and putting them all into a bowl, that is an offering, that is an adimu that can be done for Oshimare. Some people offer Oshimare when they receive Oshimare, they offer duck and they offer roosters and pigeons and guinea. So in other aspects, Oshimare may be fed slightly less animals and or a different type of animal. There's the use of popcorn as a way of cleansing and as a way of giving multiples and multiple things, like many, many eggs and many, many things that snakes are known for. There is a worship of Oshimare, and that, you know, you get sweet potato and you trace. This I learned from a person, the person that I received the Rukumi Oshimare from. You trace out of mashed sweet potato. You trace the snake and you do a worship of Oshimare there, and that becomes like, these are things that people that have Oshimare need to start doing. If you have received Oshimare, whether in Candomblé, whether in Lukumi aspect, you need to start doing some form of worship and what interaction are you having with the Oshimare that is not just the aspect of birthing the Oshimare. The point of the videos and the point of all the things and all the talks and whatever explanation I give is to encourage the practitioners of Lukumi to do other things, to pray to their Oshimare right before. Oshimare is associated with the color 7 mainly, but because Oshimare is associated with the rainbow aspect, some people want to also associate homosexuality into that. Oshimare has nothing to do with homosexuality or anything along those lines, and Oshimare is, that combination is not because of sexual orientation, that combination is just simply because people's thoughts and people's whatever. Oshimare just is an all-embracing entity. Everybody has some form of communication, and that is Oshimare. Everybody needs some form of love and some form of association and some form of correlation with other people, some form of intermingling. That is what Oshimare represents. Oshimare is that which connects. It is the umbilical cord that connects the mother to the child, and the child to the community, and the community to the whole, etc. So Oshimare is that which communicates who you are, which what you are, etc., etc. In the Lukumi aspect, Oshimare is highly associated with the Maya because of the nurturing aspect. Because Oshimare is mainly associated, like I said, with Ochum. It's interesting that again, the Eleke for Oshimare in Lukumi has taken more of the Maya feel, but even the person that I received Oshimare from likes to say Ochum Mare. Not Oshumare, but Ochum Mare. And it's interesting how the Orisha has, taken its expansion and it's doing its thing. And I have definitely already spoken with people, with Yawoses, who have had Oshumare marked in Doritas. And there is nobody who's going to come and tell me that, 35 years ago, there were people being marked to receive Oshumare on the dot. There was not. Okay, we're in 2018. Okay, it's the age of communication, so clearly Oshumare has definitely made a big impact. It is making a big impact within the communities in different aspects. Oshumare speaks highly in the Odum Odimeyi and speaks highly in the Odum Irosodi. These are two Odums in which Oshumare speaks and Oshumare comes forth in one form or another. There's other people that may say otherwise, that they may feel otherwise, etc. It is interesting that there have been other people that have messaged me and have asked me or have told me about ceremonies in which that they've done already to Oshumare, and or how the birthing ceremony was done to Oshumare, in which more elaborate things were done. So guys, the way that the transfer, this is what I tell you all, the way that the transfer of the energy of the Orisha is done from one fundamental to the other fundamental, the birthing, the consecration, and the transfer of energy, that is always up to the godfather or the person birthing, just like the person that is receiving eventually is going to be able, eventually, when they have their own ways of birthing and they've developed their own ways of the religious aspect, they will then be able to birth and or elaborate the birth that they're doing for the personal godchild. It is interesting that you guys understand. It is interesting to me to explain, to see if you guys understand, that Oshumare is that which allows one to understand another. That is another aspect of this. Without even talking, sometimes it's just simply body language is also a manifestation of Oshumare within the human race. All forms of colors, all forms of artistic expressions belong to Oshumare. The beauty of semi-precious stones, Oshumare has always been considered a very rich, very wealthy nature because Oshumare owns everything that is colorful, everything that makes happiness and that makes people like, even if the colors are black and white, those colors belong to Oshumare also. That some people don't want to use certain colors, but all colors or shades, all aspects of the spectrum belong to Oshumare. There's just several that obviously are the primary ones. Within the Lukumi aspect, there's people that they receive Oshumare because they want to reinforce their Yamaya cord, and or they want to bring happiness and stability into their life. And Oshumare is an Orisha of lots of intense wealth and lots of intense happiness and spirituality and deepening. It's an Orisha of understanding. It is an Orisha that helps you to understand life. It is not that the Orisha is going to give you all this wealth. It's that the Orisha is going to show you where all this wealth is so you can get it, so that you can see, so you can see what's hiding underneath what stone. That is an aspect of lifting a stone, and either you find a snake or you find a crystal gem, So this comes through the worship of Oshumare. And it's interesting that I have birthed Oshumare for several people, and the people that I have birthed Oshumare for have had very physical experiences with snakes after they had, like, literally with the fundamento in their hands after they have received Oshumare. And I find it interesting that there is a mental and spiritual connection that happens between fundamentals and between things and aspects, that it doesn't matter one way or the other, as long as it is worshipped and nourished, and you go forward with your spiritual growth and understanding of that aspect of that orisha, of that manifestation of God. Because God manifests in many ways, and through the spectrum of the rainbow, through the spectrum of Oshumare, God may take different forms and different shapes and different formats and different abilities and different colors and different expressions. And that is what we all see and what we all feel as different religions. In the aspect of Oshumare from Candomblé, I obviously keep normally, and I do worship or whatnot of both whatever aspect of Oshumare in the same aspect of Lukumi. So because this is an aspect of Oshumare that comes from Candomblé, as from Candomblé roots, but with more Lukumi forms. And this is strictly Lukumiso format that comes from the Lukumiso form. So Oshumare, and there's other people that have strictly like Candomblé form. So there's Oshumare has definitely been the consecration aspect of Oshumare. There's people that have already fed Oshumare four legs. There's people that are doing different things, and eventually we're forming into the crowning of Oshumare within Lukumi. I definitely would like to crown an Oshumare within Lukumi, and I'm sure that someone will definitely crown an Oshumare within Lukumi, and or in my aspect, Oshumare and Lukumi Day should definitely start being getting crowned in Lukumi, and I will crown them at some point directly, as long as with any other orisha that I see fit, that obviously does get crowned to the head, but that is a whole different story. But as part of our expansion of our religious modern day Santeria expansion, people that come to the religion and have a drawn to Oshumare and or have a interest in Oshumare, there is a lot of people that have received Oshumare nowadays. There's a lot of people who are non-initiates who have received Oshumare by now. So it's an orisha that you can see that there's an expansion of the religion, that in modern day terms, the aspect of Santeria has expanded in even the aspect of the understanding of the spirituality. So it's what are we doing now with our Oshumares that counts more so than what were they doing or what were they not doing, you know, 100 or 50 or 75 years ago. So in modern terms and in modern days, there's mixtures and things that you can do with Oshumare. Always use lots of petals of many different colors. Always use lots of popcorn. Always use different fruits, different waters. Oshumare takes things in lagoons. I went once with a priest of Candomblé, and we did a little ceremony. Well, they did a little ceremony, which I just joined, for Oshumare. They did an offering of Oshumare at the lake and whatnot. Later on, I went by myself and with a few other people later to just do a few other offerings back in the same place and a few other little things, etc., etc. Oshumare takes offerings in the woods. Oshumare takes offerings in the waters. This is why it's associated with Ochun. This is why it's associated with the Maya aspect. Oshumare is an orisha that I feel like you need to interact with this orisha. You really need to put some sort of aspect of interaction with the orisha in order for the orisha to respond back to you. Now, I think also it's interesting to note that Oshumare has become very widely accepted amongst many practitioners that many people have. And that is, again, the expansion of the religion, the expansion of the understanding, the expansion of need. There's definitely certain rituals that come in certain fundamentals that are enriching the religion in other ways that I guess we never thought possible. Oshumare definitely being one of them. In the aspect of Lucumiso and the aspect of Cuban Santeria and what most people, you know, there's a lot of people who worship Morisha in Lucumi ways, and more many people worship Morishas in African traditional ways, mainly. In the aspect of the Lucumiso, we utilize a lot of physical things or correlated things with Yemaya, with him. This is why some people then feed ram to Oshumare, whereas I'm definitely more than believe that Oshumare should be eating goat. But then again, a snake can eat anything. This is the aspect of everything that goes forward with Oshumare. People make adimuses for Oshumare. People make different things with Oshumare. You can boil eggs and make an adimu of boiled eggs for Oshumare. Boiled eggs and kimbobo pieces for Oshumare. People want to, there's no right or wrong way, but I just want to experience the way in which people are worshiping Oshumare. How are you worshiping Oshumare, and what are you doing with the worship of Oshumare? If we get all the people that have received Oshumare, and everybody definitely pays attention to how their Oshumare interacts, it's like you literally have a snake-like being that lives with you, and some of you are just letting it be there. Like, how are you interacting with this snake-like being that is in your life? And how does this colorful being interact with you? And how do you portray this colorful being in your aspect and in your life? Expressing yourself is an aspect of the worship of Oshumare. The physical expression, like your jewelry and your accessories and your clothing and your style and your colors and your hats and your little thing and your nail coloring stuff and your like lipstick and your whatever and your perfume, that which permeates, you know, is Oshumare. If you put on your colognes and you're like coming into the room and all this smell is coming off of you and all these colors are coming off of you, that is Oshumare, people. That is an aspect, that is a quality that when you receive Oshumare, you learn that there are things that you become aware. I have noticed that I have become aware of things that I do and expressions and or things that I wear in order to make other things happen. Oshumare is an orisha that makes you very aware of what you have to work with and how you're going to work with what you have. So I feel like I rambled enough about Oshumare for a while in whatever aspect and whatnot. And again, I want to focus always on the worship aspect of Oshumare. What have you done after you received Oshumare with the Sorisha? What adimuses have you placed? What things have you created? What interaction, what spiritual visions have you had with the Sorisha? When have you worn the koyar, how have you felt, etc., etc.? Oshumare, have you noted, Oshumare has to do a lot of things with business and jewels and treasures and, you know, gifts and prettiness and shiny things, you know. So what have you noticed that has increased in your life after you received Oshumare, whether in whatever tradition or with whatever fundamental that you received in Oshumare? What aspect of Oshumare, you know, how do you feel with this gem that you have received and with this gift, with this manifestation of the divine that you have received with Oshumare? That is what I'm definitely interested in hearing and or finding out. Lots of cologne and lots of perfumes and lots of beautiful things and incense. People use lots of candles, different colored candles. It's very folkloric. When Oshumare is being fed, and or a sheet cover after when Oshumare is being fed for him to consume. And there's the worship of Oshumare is definitely very beautiful and definitely taking up really good root within the Lukumi tradition. So, if you have received Oshimari, what have you done with Oshimari after you've received them? How have you worshipped them? How have you felt this energy? How have you interacted with this being? How do you salute it? Aroboboi Oshimari, Aroboboi Oshimari, Aroboboi Oshimari. May there be peace and tranquility in your life, and may there be happiness, may there be understanding and expression of your word always, a manifestation of your being. May there be beauty and abundance in your life. Aroboboi Oshimari. I hope to hear from all of you guys, and or messaging me and or send me whatever request, etc., etc. I would love to hear some of your personal worships and or see your pictures of your Oshimari shrines and your Oshimari fundamentals. Please send them forward. Tag me on it, whatever need be. And let's get together and do some Oshimari chanting, and let's get together and do some Oshimari adimu, and let's get together and do some Oshimari worship. Let's tend to Oshimari with our hands. So either way, I hope you guys have enjoyed this video. I hope you guys have learned something. I hope this has raised some sort of question in your mind. I hope you come to realize that when you watch this video about this Orisha, you notice that this Lukumi way, that the Lukumi lifestyle is alive, and it's a lifestyle that changes and modifies and sheds its skin. It sheds its skin, and Lukumi is something that becomes and adapts to its environment, just like Oshimari. Maferefum Oshimari, Maferefum Bobo Osha, Maferefum Bobo Osha Kale Aye, Maferefum Bobo Osha Kale Arao Nun. Maferefum bobo oshumari. Maferefum bobo oshumari. Maferefum bobo oshumari otamio. Bobo otamio. Bobo otamio. Maferefum oshumari. Thank you all for watching me. Thank you all for allowing me to express myself. I will see you guys in one of my next videos, and I hope and look forward to the expansion and the understanding coming forth. Ache, 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 to.